Good evening and welcome to ATV News. My name is Shalama Lawson. On today's bulletin, irrigation project remains incomplete after 7 years. Local innovators are celebrated at an event. Dance groups thrill crowds, and the Highlanders' winning ways continue. The failure by the government to complete irrigation projects in the Motare South constituency has stalled efforts by farmers to increase their crop yield and end dependence on rain-fed agriculture. Andrew Mambondiani gives us the report.
7 years on, Mpudzi irrigation scheme is still incomplete, hampering efforts by local communities in Motare South to enhance their food security. Locals blame the Minister of Agriculture for not taking steps for completing the project, which was started in 2005 under the Accelerated Irrigation Development Program. ATV spoke to villagers who are bitter over the delay in the completion of the Mpudzi Irrigation Scheme project.
Ndiyo nzvimbo yataibatsira vanhu wenzvimbo dzakawanda vanobva kubocha kunana Shazo aitenga chibage munoma sinzara yakuitika manje nekuda kwekuti dhemu iro rangomira ende mombe dzakuita zvedzinoda ipo zvekuti ringangozogumara zvirupwanyika futi.
The project is yakangomira yakadaro isu hatinombo inform wasi vagari vemunomu kuti zvamira papi ende zvakamira tichakamisa vakangoti sekutaura kwavo pachaitwa irrigation pakatoitwa nedhemu kumusoro kwacho kumupudzi dhemu but I don't know at the moment kuti chichiri kunetsa kuti inge iri functional that irrigation.
Villagers said irrigation development can improve the livelihoods of rural communities and help them to cope with current economic hardships.
Dai muno maita irrigation development zvaitibatsira nekuti iko zvinoizvi mabasa hakuna mayouth akangogara vanofanira kunga vachionawo maprojects ekuri kuzviraramisa vachiritirawo mhuri dzavo.
Villagers called on the government to complete the project to alleviate hunger in the area.
Asi kutibatsira pakurarama kwedu tichikudzawo mhuri dzedu tichirarama mukati mwazvo ndinoona sechinhu chakakosha chaizvo paupenyu. Dhemu iro rero hai dhemu rinotarisira kutaramisa kusikawo tichikwegura sezvinotarisira Mwari pakurarama kwedu.
Sekuona kwedu tinotokurudzira kuti hurumende dai yakwanisa kuita speed up that process yekuti panga paine irrigation nekuti zvinobatsirawo zvakare kuti vanhu havafi nenzara.
With the recurrent droughts in the country, irrigation development can help to improve food security. Reporting for ATV in Motare, Zimbabwe.
For decades, research findings were left to gather dust in the universities and colleges, but the forthcoming Research and Intellectual Expo is set to showcase and celebrate the work of innovative Zimbabweans. Jeffrey Moyo reports.
The Research and Intellectual Expo 2012 edition, to be held from September 5 to 7 this year, will showcase the breadth and depth of innovation by Zimbabweans. The theme for this year is Research, Innovation and Creativity for Sustainable Development.
The significance is there. It's just a pity that there has not been a working relationship between the university research centers and the business communities, the private sector. We would like to establish that so that there is a working relationship.
The professor urged government to promote value addition policies that will help generate more revenue for the country.
Any of these projects that are discovered scientifically, they need to be backed by a support system that enables them to then take ground and become established and then move forward.
The professor expressed concern over the impact of brain drain on research programs in the country.
It has been a negative impact. Some departments lost some of the key lecturers who were specialists in those particular areas, and they were some of our best researchers. So it has cost the country a good bit.
Professor Chetsanga also said there were various initiatives in polytechnics to tap fuel from coal using innovative technologies. Great Zimbabwe University Acting Chancellor Professor Herbert Chimundu said artists would have a chance to showcase their prowess at the expo.
There is a lot that is happening by way of education and training, arts education, training of trainers, and then the actual study of various artistic disciplines and performance including productions themselves. So we would like the public to see what is happening.
Professor Chetsanga said lack of funding was hampering research efforts by innovative students in tertiary institutions.
It needs then to have a support structure within the country that funds the development of that project to the finished stage where a plant, an industrial plant, can be established to go into production, and then the country benefits from that.
Reporting for ATV in Harare, Zimbabwe.
Traditional dance groups thrilled audiences in Bulawayo when they competed at the Chibuku Neshomwari Provincial Festival. The performances were rich with cultural symbolism, reflecting the spirit of the country. Selum Hlanga gives us more.
Abantu abathakazelela imigido yesintu baba lesikhathi esihle bebukele umncintiswano wamaqembu alithumi eqhudelana kumidlalo yeshibuku leshamwari. I-ATV ibikhona emcimbini lo yaxoxisana nabakhulu bezemigido.
Whichever type of dance is performed in Zimbabwe, be it chikicha, be it umchongoyo, be it whatever, as long as you go in UK, when you see what is performed in your home area, that becomes your culture there. So culture is dynamic.
Umncintiswano lo wenziwa minyaka yonke kuzigaba ezijeneyo njalo amaqembu aphumelelayo aphiwa imivuzo yemali.
Every year these events are being held, and it starts with the regions, and then you end up at a national scale. The judges for National Arts Council, they will be looking at best performers.
Amaqembu la alendlela ezijeneyo zokugida ezichaza lapho abavela khona namasiko abo. Ezinye zigoqela isichikitsha, amabhiza, imuchongoyo, lezinye eziningi.
Gurupu rangu iri inonzi Undi Zambia Chimtari. This is a group originated for Zambian cultural dance. And isusu tiriwana wakakurira muno munyika, but isusu culture yedu from Zambia atikangano.
You'd find that many people who are Zimbabweans today, they've got origins from outside Zimbabwe. So we'd have the likes of people who dance cultures like Umzansi, cultures like Zambia Gure, cultures like Chiwoda Malawi, cultures like Chimtari, cultures like Beni Arinoti, cultures like set up a dance of Botswana. We've got so many people. So Zimbabwe National Traditional Dance Association registers all traditional dance groups that are found in Zimbabwe.
Phakathi kwamaqembu lawo, imvimbi arts egida umgido wemchongo iyo eyanqobayo yathola umvuzo wamakhulu amahlanu amadola. Iqembu lekwabatsha lathola umvuzo wesibili wamadola angamakhulu amathathu. Lona lilandelwa yiChimtale, yona egida ibukisa usiko lweZambia. Abanqobayo bazaqhubekela phambili sebeqhudelana nabazinye izigaba kunyanga ezayo.
Size siye kuma final kuma competition eshibuku, saba ngunumber 1 kuma competition eshibuku. Sesimele ukuthi siye kuma final simele Zimbabwe.
NginguSelu Mhlanga, imele i-ATV koBulawayo eZimbabwe.
Highlanders Football Club continued their unbeaten run in the Castle Lager Premier League after another impressive performance. Crispin Tavura reports on the club's latest victory from Barberfield Stadium.
Highlanders extended their winning streak in the Castle Lager Premiership after they thumped Gunners 1-0 at Barberfield Stadium. A bumper crowd witnessed the match, which saw Chilamoya battling a stubborn Gunners from all fronts. Highlanders missed a lot of opportunities, sparking outrage from their legion of fans on the popular Soweto Bay. However, it was not long before the Soweto Bay turned ecstatic after Bosso scored the only goal of the match. Bosso's head coach Kelvin Kaindu expressed joy and prayed after a narrow win against fired up Gunners.
We thank God, I think we have won another game, which makes us 16-18 unbeaten. Although it was a difficult game for us, our opponents, like they said before the game, that we were coming to stop our unbeaten, but thank God we won. Despite us, I think we turned a bit complacent towards the second half when we missed quite a number of chances that we created.
Meanwhile, Ghana's coach Thanks Tengwe told ATV that his team will now be fighting relegation after their failure to win against Bosch.
We are down there at the bottom. So we need to survive, and you know, at the same time building a new team and picking up points. I think these youngsters, some of them are still young. They are taking it, they're fighting it hard, in fact, to cope with the pressure of bringing points and building and playing as a team at the same time. This is the new team. I'm saying at the end of the day, we have no excuse. We need to get the points. So we're working on that, and I'm sure we'll get them. We're very positive.
Highlanders now is 42 points in the kitty from 18 matches played so far this year. Reporting for ATV in Mulawayo, Zimbabwe.
Thank you for joining us. Good night.